Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining us. We are live here at the PVMU Soccer Stadium. Forgive us for the technical difficulties. Right now, we are 21 minutes and 38 seconds into the first half of the Lady Panthers facing off the Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi. I am your Caleb Carter, joining me alongside my partner, Jaquavis Doucette. Now, Jaquavis, the story of the game so far with the Islanders up one has been the Panthers not being able to mount up an offense. Well, what do we think about this?
Well, definitely, I believe the Panthers are playing some good defense. They do need a little bit more offense in order to make this game successful.
And we see another goal just creeps in from the Islanders.
All right, Lady Panthers lost control of the ball right there. Give another chance for the Islanders to score. Leading right now by two. Lady Panthers have zero.
Not sure who exactly was the lady who got that goal, but that one just creeps in. Goalkeeper Brooklyn Hawkins has been working her tail off back there, but just couldn't put up with the onslaught of the Islanders' offense. So Islanders up two, Panthers zero. Panthers currently working on just out. And that has been the story of the game, ladies and gentlemen. The Panthers not being able to get past midfield for much of the first half.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct. Lady Panthers are not able to get midfield right now.
But you know,
Faith Adams getting another out for Islanders.
But you know, Jaquavis, that comes with being a young team. One thing that Coach Abe Garcia said to me when we were speaking before this game started was, you know, they're currently 0-2 right now, just getting into competition, you know, trying to gear up for SWAC play. But one thing that he said was that they're still getting their rotations together, making sure all their players are on a string, getting things, you know, that chemistry together for when SWAC tournament play comes, they want to be around. Ladies and gentlemen, if you are just joining us, thank you for coming to the Prairie View A&M versus Texas A&M Corpus Christi broadcast. We're here at the PVMU Soccer Complex. The Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi currently up 2 to the Panthers 0. Another successful stop from Brooklyn Hawkins, the goalkeeper. And Jaquavis, Brooklyn Hawkins has been working her tail off back there all night. I mean, the amount of shots that the Islanders have been sending her way. And though down 2-0, she still managed to send away more than that,
yeah,
than what has been led through.
Most definitely, I will say Ms. Hawkins has been working her tail off back there as the goal kicker right there in the goal. Yeah, Caleb, and this is the home opener, the welcome back night for the PVMU women's soccer team here in the PVMU soccer complex.
All right, another stop. See, Jaquavis, and that's just been the story of the game. I mean, Brooklyn Hawkins gets her stop, but just too much offense from the Islanders for her to just put up with by herself.
Yeah,
and hopefully she's a bit slow to get up. Hopefully she's okay. But the Panthers, they're just going to have to work to get some offense going, because as we know, the old adage, sometimes a good defense is an offense, right? So the Islanders are currently up 3-0 over the Panthers.
Man, that's only 17 minutes left up in the quarter. And in the half, 17 minutes now in the counting.
A nice kick from Brooklyn Hawkins. See if 18.
Already.
Yes. Then we had a shove from number 20 of the Islanders, Miss Taylor Thibodeau, against number 18 of the Panthers, Miss Kiera Bradley. And that has also been a subplot of the game, ladies and gentlemen. A bit of chippy play from the Islanders and the Panthers.
Yes, I will definitely say that, Caleb. And refs have failed to call some of those calls when it has come to the misplaying here on the complex.
And it looks like a yellow card has been put up against number 8, I believe, Jayla Roche from the Panthers. Giving the Islanders a free kick. Opening kick from Brooklyn Hawkins, trying to get something going for the Panthers. Nice play from
another steal. Number 3,
Kamara Bradley. Now going the other way with the Islanders, number 3 of her own.
All right, that was an offsides call play. Panthers with the ball. A kick from number 5. Adia Abel.
Islanders trying to get something going. Passing off to the deep corner. Now we have Kamara Bradley from the Panthers all by herself.
Yeah, and she takes it down.
Pushing in. And just no one there along with her.
Again, that's Kamara Bradley. She's a sophomore here on campus at Prairie View A&M University.
Now number 19, Deja Lewis, trying to get something going, but leading to a collision with the Panthers and the Islanders. Not sure who the fallen Panther is just yet, but ladies and gentlemen, if you're just joining us, thank you once again. As the Panthers of Prairie View A&M University facing off against the Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi, the Islanders currently up 3-0. With 12 and a half minutes left to go in the half.
Bouncy. All right, and again, this is the first game, Texas A&M, Corpus Christi versus Prairie View A&M University, Ladies Panthers. Our upcoming game, Friday, September 8th.
I believe the Panther who was down was number 15, Nia Wilson. Now up to her feet. Glad she's okay.
All right, the ball's back on the field.
Islanders sending it off to number 3, Storm Harris, who already has a goal on the season. Goes for a shot and is defended well by the Panthers. A near offensive push from the Islanders, thwarted by the Panthers. Now Brooklyn Hawkins set to kick off. Foul called on the Islanders. giving the Panthers a bit of time to set their offense and get things going.
All right, we have nine minutes and 50 seconds left in the half.
Another chippy play between the Islanders and the Panthers. Ladies and gentlemen, that has been the story of this game.
All right, ladies. Panther Athletics would like to thank its corporate sponsors, Houston Methodist Hospital, Adidas, and Pepsi. Support the teams that support your Panthers.
Not sure what happened on the inbound for the Islanders. But Jaquavis, well attended game for the Panthers.
So I definitely would say the Panthers did bring out an audience to come out to watch their first opener home game for the Lady Panthers here at Prairie View Soccer Complex.
Vanessa Romero, midfielder, subbing in for number 16. Cielo Mazzantani for the Panthers. But yes, Jaquavis, to your point, this is the first home game of the Panther athletic season. Well attended for the Panthers. Sadly, the Panthers are currently down to the Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi 3-2-0.
Alrighty. That's out number 12.
Some good defense from the Panthers, which has been the story of the game.
It's number 12 out on Kaylin Melton. All right, and the Lady Panthers are sub for number 2, Maya Sherlin.
Graduate student Maya Sheridan out of San Antonio, coming over from the University of Kansas. Hopefully, I know one thing that Coach Abe Garcia, Jaquavis, is hoping that players like Maya Sheridan can do is provide that veteran presence to the team, because you have 11 freshmen and sophomores for the Lady Panthers and a new coach in the system. So the first thing that you always want is that veteran presence to get the players calm and collected and on the same page.
I definitely do most agree. It does take some experience to be out here to put on with the Lady Panthers, to help them continue to excel in the future. You did mention 11 freshmen and sophomore put together, right?
Yes, sir. Islanders trying to mount up an offense on the far left side of the field. Couldn't get anything going. Now the inbound from the Panthers. Back in Islander possession. Another attempt at the goal from the Islanders come up short. And that has been the story of the game, ladies and gentlemen. If you are just joining us, the Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi have been sending many shots at the goal of the Panthers.
Right, Caleb, you're right. Texas A&M up by 3, which is 5 minutes and 20 seconds left in the half.
Thank you.
Man, Caleb, I can't stop thinking about how the home side is looking right now for Prairie View A&M Lady University Lady Panthers. Just for the first game.
Very well-attended game, Jaquavis. You're absolutely right. But one thing that all of these home fans are wishing for is for the Panthers to come out with a win. And though the defense of the Panthers has been very stout, to say the least, goalkeeper Brooklyn Hawkins has been doing an amazing job. It's been tough sledding for the offense of the Lady Panthers.
Back to Kamara Bradley, taking it back down the field. Another steal from saved.
And you see Jaquavis right there. I think it showed the inexperience of the Lady Panthers team. You know, we have Kamara Bradley going down, not her first time going down the right side of the field. But sadly, she's often left alone in her pursuit. Nice job once again by the Lady Panther defense, led by defender number 11, Megan Howell, goalkeeper number 1, Brooklyn Hawkins.
Definitely some strong defense by the Lady Panthers. We just need some more offense on the field in order for the Panthers to be successful tonight game.
Shot at the goal from the Islanders, just a bit off to the right. And you know, Jaquavis, that's been the story of the season so far for the Panthers, currently with an 0-2 record. They haven't had many goals at the goal, only amounting 4 shots the entire season, while their opponents have 37 shots at the goal during this season. But like we said, the defense holding firm for the Panthers over the course of the season so far, with 17 saves for the Panthers. Ladies and gentlemen, we would like to again thank you for joining us. This is the home opener for the Panther athletic season here at the PVAMU Soccer Complex.
All righty, ladies and gentlemen, that's just one more minute left in this half. righty, and that ends the first half of our Prairie View A&M University Lady Panthers versus the Texas A&M Corpus Christi women's soccer.
Panthers currently down 0-3. Panthers down 0. Islanders up 3. We will step aside. Thank you again for joining us at the PVAMU Soccer Complex. Panther Athletics would like to thank its corporate sponsors, Houston Methodist Hospital, Adidas, and Pepsi. Support the teams that support your Panthers.
Panther fans, are you ready for some football? PVMU football will travel to take on rival Texas Southern University at the Shell Energy Stadium tomorrow, Saturday, September 2nd. Kickoff is set for 7 p.m. Tickets are on sale and can be purchased at www.seatgeek.com. Come support your Panthers. For all the latest news on Panther Athletics, visit the official website at pvpanthers.com. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok by visiting at pvpanthers. Make sure to tag us on your Instagram pics for all PV athletic contests at pvpanthers.
The Lady Panthers volleyball team will hit the hardwood for the home season opener against Tarleton State on Tuesday, September 12th. The first serve is for 6 p.m. in the William Nix Baby Dome. Make sure to come out and support your Lady Panthers.
Ladies and gentlemen, mark your calendars for the next PVAMU home soccer match next Friday, September 8th for a 7 p.m. matchup against the University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley, here at the PVAMU Soccer Complex. Alrighty, tag us on your Instagram, Snapchat, and Twitter photos. Shout us out at PV Panthers.
Hello and welcome back to the Lady Panthers of Prairie View A&M University facing off against the Islanders of Texas A&M University Corpus Christi. The score is currently 3 Islanders to Panthers 0. And Jaquavis, as we get the second half of this matchup started, what are you looking for the Panthers to get things going back in their favor?
I definitely will say the Panthers do have to step up the offense a little bit more. They have to show some really good defense out here on the field, but we need a little bit more offense in order to be able to score some points here tonight. So let's see if after the half, the Ladies Panthers came back a little bit stronger than they were the first half.
And Jaquavis, I think we just saw a microcosm of what this game has been. Brooklyn Hawkins coming up with the save, as the Islanders look to mount up a formidable offense. Panthers getting things going with number 3, Kamara Bradley.
Yeah, Miss Bradley has been showing out all night. I would say Miss Bradley and Hawkins definitely stuck out to me throughout the game tonight.
Absolutely. Now with the Panthers in Islanders territory, we look to see what they can do on this side of the field. Thank you. Number 13 for the Panthers, Vanessa Romero, setting off with the corner kick. Intercepted by the Islanders and recovered by the Panthers. Ladies and gentlemen, right in front of our face, the chippy play that has plagued this game. Another instance of it. And Jaquavis, if some of our listeners were here in person, they would hear what we are hearing. The Panther faithful begging the refs to throw a card.
And I will say that's been going on all night today's game.
Nice play from number 5, Adia Abel of the Panthers. Now the Islanders trying to advance the ball into Panthers territory. Leaving it up to Brooklyn Hawkins. Definitely an aggressive play, to say the least, from number 2, Maya Sheridan of the Panthers, rewarded for her aggression. Islanders looking to mount an attack. But once again, that stout Panthers defense coming into play. A go-at-the-goal pass to Aaliyah Ramadan of the Islanders, who already has a goal in the contest. And another attempt come up short from the Islanders.
Welcome to the ones that's just joining us. 39 minutes and 50 seconds left in the second half. Lady Islanders up by 3 points and Panthers 0.
Nice entry kick from Brooklyn Hawkins, won by the Islanders. Panthers looking to take back control. Ball sent into Islanders territory, giving the Islanders a bit of a chance to regroup and set up their offense. Offsides called by the referee on number 99, Aaliyah Ramadan of the Islanders. A call, quite frankly, Jaquavis, that many of the Panther faithful have been looking for all night.
Yeah, I will say the fans out here have been calling, asking the ref to call the right calls all night.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, just wanted to remind you about our game, our soccer game, September 8th, Friday, September 8th, here at the PVAMU Soccer Complex, 7 p.m., versus the University of Rio Grande Valley. That is September 8th, Friday, 7 p.m., versus the University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley.
As we begin to settle in to the second half of this contest between the Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi versus the Panthers of Prairie View A&M. The Panthers looking to make quick work in getting back into this contest. Some nice footwork there by number 99. Aaliyah Ramadan.
So we're saying we were hoping that the Panthers came back and played a little bit stronger the second half of the game, which is 36 minutes left in this half.
We once again would like to thank you for joining us in this, the opening home contest of Prairie View A&M Athletics. The next contest we have coming up is a football game. Excuse me, check that. That would be the soccer game where the Panthers face off against the University of Rio Grande Valley. And then the football game where the Panthers of Prairie View A&M take on Abilene Christian in their home opener in Panther Stadium.
And we mentioned football. I would say tomorrow is set to play Texas Southern University, our rival here at Prairie View A&M University, tomorrow at the Shell Energy Stadium. Tomorrow, September 2nd, the kickoff is set for 7 p.m. Tickets are still on sale and can be purchased at www.seatgeek.com. Come support your football and your Panthers.
And that, Jaquavis, is a game I don't think many would like to miss, as we know the history of that rivalry between Prairie View and Texas Southern. The Lady Panthers seeming to mount some offense, stopped by the Islanders of Texas A&M Corpus Christi. But Jaquavis quickly getting back to that game tomorrow versus Texas Southern for our football players. That is a game that many of the Panther faithful out there will be attending.
I would say so. Houston. I would say so. That is known as our Labor Day Classic versus Texas Southern University, our rival here at PVAMU. Yeah, while we're talking about football still, I want to talk about how last year during our Labor Day Classic, the Panthers took home 40 while Texas Southern University had 23. With some more player shout-outs for the PVAM University Athletics, let's talk about our SWAC Sweat Setter of the Week of the women's volleyball team for Prairie View AM University. That's Leah Lawson. Leah Lawson is the SWAC Setter of the Week here at Prairie View and for the SWAC Conference.
The Islanders, oh! Nice play by Brooklyn Hawkins for the Panthers, stopping the offense of the Islanders. Panthers and the Islanders going back and forth, trying to gain possession. Now we're going to take another look at that stop by Brooklyn Hawkins. An amazing defensive play by the goalkeeper for Prairie View A&M.
Yeah, I would say Brooklyn Hawkins has definitely been putting in the work all tonight in tonight's game, which is 32 minutes left in the second half. Let's see, that was another save by Kamara Bradley. Let's see, Brooklyn Hawkins saved the ball.
And you see, Jaquavis, that is the type of veteran presence that the Panthers are wanting from their players, such as Brooklyn Hawkins. She's a graduate student coming over from the University of Idaho, and her experience speaks for itself as she comes up with another save for the Panthers. Number 20, Julius Suico for the Panthers, coming in for number 15, Nia Wilson, at that midfield position. The Panthers looking to get on the scoreboard with just over 30 minutes left to go in the game. Nice play by defender Megan Howell. Ball now in Islander territory as they look to go up the right side of the field. Number 3, Storm Harris from the Islanders, outrunning the Panther defender, only to be stopped once again by Brooklyn Hawkins.
All right, Caleb, let's get back to our Southwestern Athletic Conference Setter of the Week, and that is here on campus at Prairie View University, Leah Lawson. For the week, Lawson averaged an impressive 7.4 assists per set, compiling 97 assists over 2 wins and the loss during the Texas Invite. In the team's 5-set win over the Northern Arizona, the first Lady Panther dished out 53 assists with 11 digs and 1 service ace. She racked up 28 assists and come from behind against host team Charlton in 5 sets and had 1 service ace and 13 digs and 3-2 win. Substitution.
definitely want to shout out Miss Leah Lawson for being the Southwestern Athletic Conference Setter of the Week. You know, Jaquavis, the volleyball team, the soccer team, excuse me, not the only team with a different coach at the helm, with the volleyball team having a new coach as their leader. Coming back to soccer, nice play from defenders Megan Howell and number 8, Jalen Roche, but Islanders looking to make an attack. Storm Harris with the ball. Tried to take on the entire Panther defensive unit by itself. Circling quickly back to the women's volleyball. The Lady Panthers at the volleyball team are currently 2-3, coming off a loss, versus Arkansas State, 0-3, but we'll be taking on the University of Rio Grande Valley tomorrow in Houston.
Right, Caleb, I'm so happy and glad that you mentioned that. Also, don't forget, September 8th, our soccer team will also be taking on University of Texas Rio Grande Valley as well. That is September 8th. So tomorrow, September 2nd at 3 p.m., you can catch our women's volleyball team playing University of Texas Rio Grande Valley. September 8th, you can catch our soccer team playing the same team, 7 p.m. PVAMU Soccer Complex.
Another great defensive stop by Brooklyn Hawkins for the Panthers. Great end kick. Now in Islander control. An attempt at the goal failed by the Islanders. And another goal for the Islanders. Coming off a bit of chippy play. making the score now. Texas A&M University, Corpus Christi 4, Prairie View A&M University 0. That goal for the Islanders coming from number 17, Gracie Gill, excuse me. The Panthers looking to do anything to get some points.
That's what we're talking about right here, Caleb. The Panthers have to play a little bit more offense in order for us to succeed for tonight with just 22 more minutes left in the second half.
And ladies and gentlemen, if you hear me and my partner, Jaquavis, constantly mentioning the Panthers' offense or the lack thereof, the reason being is because this has been the story of the season so far. This being the Panthers' third game, they have only mounted 4 shots at the goal and 2 goals to show for it, while their opponents have amassed up 37 shots at the goal and 11 points over the course of their 2 previous games. And that just isn't something that leads to winning soccer. I believe that is number 6. Excuse me, check that, number 8 for the Panthers, Jayla Roche, on the ground currently. Hopefully she's all right. We're back with the Panthers of Prairie View A&M University down 0-4 against the Lady Islanders of Texas A&M University Corpus Christi with just a bit over 20 minutes left in the contest.
That's right, just 20 minutes left in the game here. Lady Islanders are still up. We're sitting here wondering if our Panthers are going to be able to play some good offense.
That has been the question of the day.
Most definitely.
Can the Panthers sustain their offense?
For all your latest news on Panther Athletics, visit the official website at pvpanthers.com. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram by visiting at PV Panthers. Make sure to tag us on your Instagram pics from all of PV Athletics contests at PV Panthers.
Nice go-ahead kick by number 22, Naloni Algier. Send a hit to number 7 of the Islanders, but an offside called.
Don't forget to mark your calendars for the next PVAMU home soccer match next Friday, September 8th, for a 7 p.m. matchup against University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley, here at the PVAMU Soccer Complex.
Goal attempt from the Islanders coming. And is successful by the Islanders. Making the score, Islanders 5, Panthers 0.
That's with just 16 minutes left in the second half. Man, Caleb, ever since just sitting here tuned into the game, we're so close to the stadium right now. I'm just hearing the Marching Storm band playing right now and practicing right now. Just to mention, are you ready for some football? PVMU football will travel tomorrow to take on our rival, Texas Southern University, at the Shell Energy Stadium. Again, that's tomorrow, Saturday, September 2nd. Kickoff is set for 7 p.m. Tickets are still on sale, and you can be purchased at www.seatgeek.com. Come support your Panthers and the sound of that Marching Storm band.
Circling back to the field of play, Panthers currently down 5-0. Panthers doing a good job getting the ball. It's number three, Kamara Bradley. Looking for someone to come along with her.
All right, that was a great pass by number 24, Johnson, to Kamara Bradley, number three.
Ball currently in Islander territory, getting set for a kickoff from their goalkeeper.
Those just joining us with 14 minutes just left in the second half.
Ladies and gentlemen, we once again would like to thank you for joining us here at the PVAMU Soccer Complex as the Lady Panthers of Prairie View A&M University take on the Islanders of Texas A&M University Corpus Christi. Still early in the soccer season, the Panthers looking to get things going.
That's absolutely right, Caleb. You said it's still early in the soccer season, and we just start welcome bite night for our women Panthers and our Lady Panthers soccer team tonight. You join us again next week, September 8th, as our Lady Panthers take on the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley here at the PVAMU.
Some nice play once again. Sorry to interrupt, Jaquavis, from Kamara Bradley.
Yeah, that's another one top player I've noticed tonight. Ms. Bradley has been working really hard tonight here on the field, as well as our other Lady Panthers.
As we see this once again from Kamara Bradley, trying to get a shot at the goal against the Islanders. Another goal at the goal from the Islanders. Come up a bit short. The defense for the Panthers, once again, doing a fantastic job at withstanding the barrage from the Islanders.
Substitution for the Lady Panthers, number six.
Panthers looking to make an offense. Kamara Bradley deep in the right side corner. Not a bad shot. The Islanders coming close, but once again, an amazing stop by Brooklyn Hawkins. That veteran leadership showing up for the Panthers once again. Attacking the offense of the Islanders and putting it to rest. Some questionable officiating from the refs. Once again, great defense from the Panthers. And Jaquavis, even though that ball was a bit high on that goal shot, one thing that can't be mistaken is that Brooklyn Hawkins was right there. Right now we have a Panther down on the field. Hopefully she's okay.
Just take a look at that replay. As you can see right now, our Lady Panther is now back up on her feet. Support of some trainers and a coach. It's number 5. Adia Abel.
Thank goodness Ms. Abel is okay. And Jaquavis, as this game starts to wrap up, we start looking ahead as to what the Lady Panthers have coming up for the rest of the season. Still currently in out-of-conference play, as their next game is against the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley, September 8th, in the PVAMU complex. But, you know, Jaquavis, I talked to Coach Abe Garcia, and one thing that he said to me was that, you know, since this is a young team with 11 freshmen and sophomores on the team, you know, we can expect these type of, you know, just getting the team together performances. They're getting that continuity together. First time many of them are playing together this season under a new coach in Coach Abe Garcia. But one thing that can be said is as Coach Garcia returns to Prairie View for his 11th season, is that he is a winning coach. During his 10 seasons with Prairie View, he allowed for the team to go to the SWAC tournament in each of his 10 previous seasons, allowing the team to go to the semifinals in 6 of those appearances, going to the championship twice, and in the NCAA tournament one time. So we know Coach Abe Garcia is a winning coach. We know he can establish a winning culture. But it just takes time to get that continuity together.
That's because I will say here, our PVAMU athletics champions are built here at Prairie View AMU University.
And one thing that we can't also forget, Jaquavis, is the stock that many of these players are used to. Senior players like Megan Howell, Elizabeth Aguero, these are players who were here during the championship season. With that being said, though, Jaquavis, we know that PVMU soccer has a winning culture built in it. Champions are built here, and we can't wait to see the soccer team get back to their winning ways.
Know that right? With just 4 minutes and 20 seconds left in the second half, I would say champions are built here in the athletic department at Prairie View AM University, and that is because excellence lives here.
Some shifty footwork from the Islanders. I was going to say even better defense from the Panthers. But number 9 from the Islanders, Mylisa Atis, doing her best Megan Rapinoe impression to get goal number 6 for the Islanders.
Again, that's number 9, Mylisa from Miami, Florida. Panthers with just 3 minutes left in 50 seconds in the second half. We want you to mark your calendar for the next PVAMU home soccer match next Friday, September 8th, for a 7 p.m. matchup against the University of Texas, Rio Grande Valley, here at PVAMU Soccer Complex. Don't forget to tag us on your Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, and other social media platforms at PV Panthers. Panther Athletics would also like to thank its corporate sponsors, Houston Methodist Hospital, Adidas, and Pepsi. Support the teams that support your Panthers.
Nice footwork by Kamara Bradley. Going up against a host of Islanders. The crowd expecting a card from the referee. Kamara Bradley on the ground. Hopefully she's okay. One thing that can't be mistaken is the effort that the Panthers are putting on the field today. The ball just not going their way.
And again, Caleb. All right, that's another sub for the Lady Panthers. Sub number 22. Miss Algier. Again, Caleb, with just 2 minutes in the court, in the half. All I can continue to hear is that Marching Storm band playing in the background at the Panther Stadium. That's just to remind you all that Panther fans, you ready for some football? PVAMU will be traveling to take on a rival, Texas Southern University, tomorrow. Tickets are still on sale and can be purchased at www.seatgeek.com. Don't forget to come support your Panther football.
A go at the goal from the Panthers. Come up a bit short. And as this game enters its final seconds, Panthers currently down 6-0 against Texas A&M Corpus Christi. But we do expect our Lady Panthers to bounce back on September 8th when they take on the University of Texas Rio Grande Valley back here at the PVAMU Soccer Complex.
All right, that's just 1 more minute left in the game here for the Lady Panthers versus the Lady Islanders. It's 30. 29.
And the contest has concluded between the Islanders of Texas A&M University Corpus Christi as they win 6-0 over the Panthers of Prairie View A&M 0. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to thank you again for joining us during this broadcast here at the PVAMU Soccer Complex. Hopefully you can tune in once again as the Panthers take on University of Texas Rio Grande Valley September 8th back here at the PVAMU Soccer Complex. But for those football fans, we have a big game coming up tomorrow against rival Texas Southern University at Shell Energy Stadium in Houston. Be sure to check that game out.
And again, for all your latest news on Panther Athletics, visit the official website at pvpanthers.com. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok by visiting PV Panthers. Make sure to tag us on your Instagram pics for all PV athletic contests at PV Panthers. And again, I'm Jaquavius Doucet. Thank you all so much for joining us tonight.
Thank you for joining us. Thank you for joining me and my partner, Jaquavius Doucet. I'm Caleb Carter. Thank you for watching Prairie View A&M University PV AMU Panthers on YouTube.